Students in this online tutorial class, and this is our topic for this session. What is it? Roman numerals, or you can say Roman numerals system, right? So what will be our main focus in this session? To know about Roman numerals and how to write Roman numerals, and then what are the different rules to write the numbers in Roman numerals system. So first, before going to those things, to know about Roman rules and what's it, whatever it is, first we should know that these numbers 1, 2, or you can say 0 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Okay, so we have been using these numbers, and these numbers we use in Hindu, Arabic numeral system. Okay, this is called, in which system we use these numbers? This is called Hindu Arabic numeral system. Okay, so there is another system which used in other places, or you can say in other countries. So that system is, that is Roman numeral system. What we call that one? Roman numerals system. And if we see the use of Roman numerals, you can take a general example. Suppose in your school timetable, these are the classes. The classes are written in Roman numerals. Suppose there's first class, second class, okay, then third class, then fourth class, and so on. So all the classes are written in Roman numerals. Okay, and then you see in clock, so in clock you see the numbers used in Roman, the number we use, that is Roman numeral. Okay, then this one, and this one, and then so on. Okay, so these are the common uses of Roman numerals. Then we know that you are aware that for these numbers, you are aware that what are the symbol for this one in your Roman numerals. For 1, this will be 1. For 2, it will be. For 3, it will be. Okay. Then 4, 4, it will be. Then for 5, this is. For 6, this one. For 7, this one. For 8, this one. For 9, this one. And for 10, you know that. What is for 10? That is this one, x. Okay. Now before going to the rule for Roman numeral system, you must keep some values in mind. Okay. And those values are some standard Roman numerals symbol. Okay. So that one is the for 10 that I have already written here. For 50, it will be L. For 100, it will be C. For 500, it will be D, and for 1000, it will be this one. Okay, so these are the some standard symbols for in Roman numeral system. Now we are going to see the rule for writing the numbers in Roman numeral system. जो numbers को आप जो है हिंदू अरेबिक सिस्टम में जो नंबर्स हैं, हाउ टू राइट दोज नंबर्स इन रोमन न्यूमरल सिस्टम. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट रूल. सो व्हाट वी आर सीइंग हियर, रूल्स फॉर रोमन न्यूमरल्स सिस्टम. व्हाट आर द रूल्स? ओके, सो फर्स्ट वन इज what is the first rule, and what first rule says that if a symbol is repeated, then its value get added. Okay, its value get added as many times it occurs, or you can say it repeats. Now, ये first rule, okay, if we see what is written here, if a symbol is repeated, okay, then its value get added as many times it occurs. So what is the meaning of this line? Suppose you can take an example. Okay, we know very well that for 10 the Roman numeral symbol is this one, okay, and suppose you are writing for this one, for 20 you have to write for 20. So for 20 the symbol is Roman numeral symbol is double X. So what is the meaning of here X? So X is repeating 2 times. So that means how did you get 20? 20 kaise aaya? 10 plus 10. Okay, this is equal to 20. Right? So here X is repeating 2 times, that's why its value will added 2 times. X is 2 bar repeat ho raha hai, isliye iska value 2 bar add hoga. Okay. Same is what is the Roman numeral symbols for 30? This one. Okay. Now look at here, how many times X are repeating? 3 times. So its value get added 3 times. Iske 3 bar hoga. Okay. This one is 30. That's why I have written here, if a symbol is repeated then its value get added as many times it occurs. Okay, jitne bar ye aayega utne bar uski value add hogi. So you can take this an example. Here X is repeating 3 times, that's why its value is added 3 times. Okay, and then same for here, X is repeating 2 times, its value is added 2 times. Okay, then what is the second rule? No symbol can repeat it more than 3 times. No symbol can repeat more than 3 times. Okay, कोई भी सिंबल जो है 3 बार से ज्यादा रिपीट नहीं होता है. एंड सिंबल्स B, L and T never repeated. Okay. So let us see what this line is saying. Okay, and what is the meaning of this line? So here no symbol can repeat more than 3 times. कोई भी symbol 3 से ज्यादा बार repeat नहीं हो सकता है. And symbols B, L and T. B is symbol for 5. This one is for 50. And this one is for 500. Okay, so these symbols never repeat. ये कभी भी repeat नहीं करेंगे. Let us see example how we can understand it in better way. ठीक है ना, कैसे हम इसको जो है अच्छे तरीके से समझ सकते हैं. So here example, suppose you are writing here, what is the symbol for 30? Roman symbol, that is X, X, X. And if we say that for 40 it must be X, 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 but it is not true. Okay, this is wrong because no symbol can repeat more than 3 times, that I have written here. And the symbol for 50 is later we will discuss for in another rule, because there is another rule for this one. So for 40 there is a symbol XL. Okay, this is 40. So what in earlier what we discussed, that the common use of Roman numerals, this is also rule. You have seen that in many search this is written, that is XL and double XL. Okay, you have heard what the size of a search. Okay, so this cannot be repeated. And if you see here, suppose this one we write, because here this value is repeating 2 times, so this is for 7. Now this value is repeating 3 times, this value is 8. But you never see such type of number in Roman numeral. We cannot write it 9. Okay, because here this symbol is repeating 4 times. So this is not correct. This is wrong. All this is right. Okay. So what is our conclusion here? That no symbol repeated more than 3 times. More than 3 times कोई भी symbol जो है repeat नहीं होगा. तो यहाँ पे जो है, now you see this is 8, but this can not be 9. For 9 this is, there is a symbol, that is IX. Okay, and V, L and D, you never see that these symbols repeated. We cannot see such type of number at V, V, X. You cannot see such type of Roman numerals number. Okay, this is wrong. Okay, because here v is repeating two times. So what here what we have concluded from here that v, l and d never repeated, ye teenu kabhi bhi repeat nahi honge. Okay, and then now we are going to what is the third rule. Okay, what third rule says. Okay, so if a symbol of smaller value, okay, if a symbol of smaller value is in the left to, or first we are going to see what if a symbol of smaller value is in the right to the symbol of greater value. Okay, if a symbol of smaller value is in the right to the symbol of greater value, then its value get added to the value of greater symbol. Okay, so now look at here. Let us see what this line is saying, or is we have written here. ये lines में क्या लिखे हुए हैं तो okay. So here if a symbol of smaller value is in the right to the symbol of greater value, then its value get added to the value of greater symbol. So this is what we can take here. This is example. Okay. So now look at here. Suppose what is the symbol for which is the this number, this Roman numeral symbol is for 6. Okay, but how did he get 6? So here this one is greater symbol. Okay, this one is smaller. Now look at here, because this is a smaller symbol and this is in the right of greater symbol, so its value will get added to the value of greater symbol. So what is the value of for this one? This is symbol of 5 and this is symbol of 1. So here what we 5 plus 1, that's why we will do 6. Okay, same you can take another example. Suppose you have to write for x, I mean, okay, what? So this is the symbol of 14. Right, so why? Because here this is smaller and this is greater, we know that. So how did you get that? This is greater because this is the symbol, x is symbol for 10 and this one is for what? For 4. Okay, so how did you get this one is 10 plus 4, 14, and then so on for other numbers. So what is our main focus here? That if a symbol of smaller value is in the right of a symbol of greater value, then the value of symbol of smaller value will get added to the symbol of greater value. As you see that here, this one I is smaller than v. Okay, its value is smaller than v, the value of v. Okay, that's why it get added here. इसको यहाँ पे add हो गया. ऐसे same आप यहाँ पे भी देखोगे. This is symbol of 4 and this is symbol of 10. So this is in the left right of this one. So if it is in the right of and right of greater symbol, then its value will get added to value of this one. Okay. So simple meaning what we have learned here, that if a symbol of smaller value is in the right of greater value, then its value will added to the value of greater symbol. Okay, now fourth one, or we can change this one there is no need to write whole thing here. Now here, if a symbol of smaller value is in the left, okay, what we are writing here is in the left to the symbol of greater value, then its value get subtracted. Okay, get subtracted from the value of greater symbol. Okay, so let us see what is the meaning here. If a symbol of smaller value is in the left, in earlier, in third rule, what it was, the symbol of smaller value was in right to the symbol of greater value. But here the symbol of smaller value is in the left of symbol of greater value. So if a symbol of smaller value is in the left to the symbol of greater value, then its value get, in this case the value will get subtracted. Okay, so you what we see, you can take a general example, a simple example. Suppose this one, all of you know that this is a symbol of 4. Okay, but how did you get here? This one is smaller, okay, and this one is greater. Now you know very well that symbol 4, this one is symbol of 5 and this is symbol of 1. Okay, so here smaller is in the left of greater. Okay, symbol of smaller value is in the left of the symbol of greater value. That's why how we get, that's why its value will subtracted from value of this one. This one is 5 minus 1 is equal to 4. Okay, and now we can see another example. Two or three example we can take here. Suppose what I am taking here, that I have told you that this is what is the symbol, this is XL. XL is the symbol of 40. Okay, now how did you get 40? Because X, symbol for X is 10 and symbol for L is, you know very well, that 50. So which is smaller? This one is smaller. Okay, and this one is greater. So what we have now, according to this one, the symbol of smaller value is in the left of the symbol of greater value. That's why its value get subtracted and this will be 50 minus 10. That's why the symbol of this one will be 40 XL. Okay, that I have told you earlier, that okay, because you cannot write 40 like this one. No symbol can repeat more than 3 times. Koi bhi symbol 3 se jyada baar repeat nahi ho sakta hai. So in this way you can write another numbers. So this is the third and fourth. What are third and fourth? What third and fourth rule says that if a symbol of smaller value is in the right of the symbol of greater value, then its value will get added to the symbol of greater value. And if it is in the left of the symbol of greater value, then its value will get subtracted from the symbol of greater value. That's why these two rules says third and fourth. Okay, next one is what is fifth one. Okay, so what is fifth? Symbols V, L and D never subtracted. Okay, so what is the meaning of here? Symbols V, L and D never subtracted means, that is, symbols V, L and D, symbols B, L and D, when these are never subtracted, simple meaning these three symbols will be never to the left of the greater value. Okay, so that is, symbols B, L and D are never to the left of greater value of greater symbol. Okay, these V, L and D are never to the left of, this is not left of, okay, the symbol of okay. So when these three symbols are not in the left of the greater value, then they will never subtract it. Suppose this one is not possible. Okay, so you never see such type of Roman numerals symbol. So because if according to rule what we have learned in third and fourth, so this is smaller and this is greater, so this would be 10 minus 5, so this will become 5, but this is not possible because for 5 this is the symbol. Okay, so that's why what this rule says, that B, L and D are never subtracted, means they will never in the left side of the greater value of the greater symbol. This is 10, this is the symbol for 10, this is the symbol for 10, so this is not, whole process is not possible. Okay, then what sixth rule says, that this is the symbol for first. Okay, for one we write like this one, first is subtracted only from V and you can say X. Okay, now you see this one, 5 minus 1 is equal to 4, and this is the symbol of 9, so 10 minus 1 is equal to 9. Okay, so this symbol is subtracted, symbol you can say symbol I is subtracted only from V and X. Okay, and next is seventh rule. What seventh rule says, that symbol X subtracted only from, okay, symbol X is subtracted only from L, C and M only. Okay, so this symbol subtracted only from L. L is the symbol for 50 and C is the symbol for 100. Okay, and M is the symbol for 1000. So if you see this one, if we check this one, we know that what is the symbol for 90. For 90 the symbol is XC. Okay, why this is XC? Because here, look at here, C is a symbol for 100. Okay, and X is a symbol for 10. So XC, according to rule third, the value rule fourth, what is our rule fourth? If the value of smaller symbol is in the, or you can say, if a symbol of smaller value is in the left of the symbol of greater value, then its value will get subtracted from larger value of larger symbol. So this is larger here and this is smaller, 100 minus 10, that is equal to 90. Okay, so this is the symbol for 90. That's why this rule says that X symbols subtracted only from L, M and L, C and M. Okay, now these are the rules, and by using these rules you can write the Roman numerals number easily. Okay, from Hindu Arabic numeral system. Okay, and I'm giving you some examples. Suppose this is 65, you have to write the given numbers in Roman numerals system. Okay, so this number, how to write? We know that 60 can be written as 60 plus 5. Okay, now for 5 we know that what is the Roman numerals symbols, and for 60 how can you write? For 60 you know that what is the symbol for 50, L is the symbol for 50. Okay, so L, and if you add here 10, you will get 60. So we know that by rule third, if a symbol of smaller value is in the right of the symbol of greater value, then its value get added to the symbol of greater value. So here this one is 50 plus 10, so 60. So we know that what is the symbol, this one is LX, symbol for 60 is LX, and symbol for 5 is this one. So we can write it LXB, or simply you can write here LXB. Okay, right. So for 60, suppose you have to write for another number. Suppose you want to write for 85, you want to write, okay. So suppose you have to write for 85. For 85, what will be symbol? You can write it 80 plus 5, or you can write it what? We can write it 50 plus 30 plus 5. So what is the symbol for 50? That is for 50, this is L. For 30, we know that there are 3x, and for 5, we know that this one. Okay. So this is the symbol for 85. And so for other numbers. So by using the rules, you can easily write the symbols for other numerals numbers. Those are not standard. By keeping the mind of standard numeral system, you can write, and by keeping the rules in mind, you can write the Roman numeral symbols for any number. Okay, so thank you. I hope you have understood this one. Whatever we have learned in this exercise. Okay, thank you.